Can you hear me? Whoops. Okay, hang on a second. Testing, testing, testing. Because I can't see the screen once I leave my computer. Lost my viewers again. Anybody else on there? The trials and tribulations of live. Hello? Spinning. There it is. Okay, I'm up. Okay, how about now? There we go. I see people. Can you hear me now? Can you see me? It takes a minute because there's a delay. There I go. See me now? Somebody please type. Thank you. Oh, God. Ugh. This is why I need an assistant full time. All right. Okay, I'm just got the headphones on so I can see if I'm on here or not. Okay. Oh, Lord. What happened was I lost the camera that's up there. I think that happened when the computer crashed. Sorry about that. So I had to unplug it and plug it back in so the computer could see it. Anyway, I can't see the screen, so I don't know who's on or not. Hang on, let me just go double check it. Mr. Tom, you made it. How you doing, Mr. Tom? Okay. Well, thank you again. The glitches. Of course, in the testing, everything works fine. You know, it's always that way. And then we can always talk about Mercury retrograde. Anyway, I would like you to get comfortable. So relax, sit back or lie back, or if you want to do yoga, meditate. I'm going to play some bowls. We'll go maybe an hour or so. I don't know, somewhere in there, 45 minutes, an hour. I'm going to play some bowls. I'm going to play some gongs. And we'll just let it happen, okay? Excuse me. And there you go. So, get comfortable. Sit back and relax. Lie back and relax. Close your eyes. If you got headphones, put them on. Or if you have a really good speakers, the sound quality should be really good. And it sounds pretty good in my headphones here. I don't have my speakers on out over there because if I did, it would cause feedback. But I have three sets of bowls up. So that's 4, 6, 8, 9. That's 17. 28 singing bowls, 27, something like that. It's three sets. The front row that I'm playing will be the Monopore set, which is my antique, really special bowls. The middle row is the, I call it the Nepali set. It's the set that I put together when I was in Nepal. And the back row is the Japanese temple bowl set, Rengong bowls. To my right, your left, is a 36-inch sun gong. Above that is a 30-inch moon gong. And next to that is a 24-inch sunburst gong. This is a 48-inch Chinese chow. And this is a 40-inch Nepalese chow. So that's the hardware I got. And I have one more bowl, so maybe that's 29 bowls. This one I got in Nepal also. So sit back, relax, and we're going to get on with it. So everybody, take a deep breath in, slowly, gently, in through the nose, out through the mouth, and pause. Take another deep breath in. Release. And you're allowed to exhale loudly, because what that does is the very last part of your breath will escape from you. A second. Take another deep breath. Slowly and gently. And release. Ah. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take a deep breath in. And let it out slow and gentle. Take another deep breath. One more time. And I want to thank you for joining me. It's my pleasure to be able to do this. I can honestly say if I wasn't sober, still sober, I wouldn't be here. I would definitely not be alive. And there would be no way that I could be able to perform this or do any of this or have any of what I do. So I'm grateful to be able to do this and continue to do this. I am working on a subscription service so I can keep the doors open. Up until now, mostly donations online, but I need to evolve, just like I evolved away from streaming on Facebook. Again, we had a little glitch earlier. The computer shut down because I turned the fan off because I didn't want the fan noise to interfere with the microphone. And because of that, it overheated. So I will remember that the next time around. You run through the trials and tribulations as you go, just like in life. You figure it, you know, you come up with something, a problem, you figure it out, and you keep moving forward. So anyway, I'm working on a subscription service. I haven't quite figured that all out yet. I'm looking at several avenues. Above all is the sound quality. Eventually, I'll have a better camera system. But as long as the sound is there and it's coming across clear and crisp and full ranged, and I need you to tell me this, you know, if you want to private message me, or if you want to make a post on the page or on Twitch here or wherever it is, the chat and messages, or publicly post it saying, hey, that was awesome, hey, the sound was great. Don't be afraid to tell me if it's not working, because I need to know what works and what doesn't work. Because I don't know until I turn everything off and shut her down. And also, my gear is a lot better than a lot of other people's. So when I hear something, I hear it differently. I do listen back on my phone and my iPad and my computer at home, but even still, I have better than average for a lot of my stuff because I'm always working on perfecting my sound and what I listen to. It's my thing. And I didn't mention it earlier, but that's probably a huge part of how I managed to stay sober also, is getting involved in all this. Because it really takes me to places that I thought I could get there with drugs and alcohol. And I can tell you honestly, I've traveled mentally, sonically, emotionally, spiritually with these instruments much further, wider, better, faster than any drug-induced state I was at, or alcoholic state I was ever at. I mean, I've got stories about playing, and I really should probably consider writing them into a book or something, or a blog or a memoir, I don't know, of some of the journeys that I've, and I still remember them. That's the best part, is I still remember what I experienced, where I was, where, you know, where I went. Whereas if I was still using, well, actually, if I was still using, if I was still alive using, let's be more specific, there's no way in heck I would remember some of this stuff. It would have to be really profound. But then back then, I thought everything was profound, so there you go. But I can tell you this, in doing this live, and I miss playing for people. So one last thing, I'm working on a possibility of an all-day sound bath, small group sound bath. So what that means is, I would take small groups in. I'm allowed three people upstairs in the chapel room. I've done events up there. We have a chapel room in the building here because this building used to be an old convent. It's almost a 100-year-old convent. Anyway, I'm allowed to bring small groups in. So what I could do is possibly book out the chapel room all day. And then we'll have time slots, and we could do small groups of three or four people to get a live in-person sound baths, socially distanced. We could figure that out. My idea would be a small setup. I wouldn't bring the whole entourage up, but I could set it up in the middle of the room and have everybody coming off the sides, three or four people, so that you're close enough, but further enough away to be socially distanced for the time being. And we can run sessions like every hour, let's say hypothetically, and there'll be a flat fee, and you book your time. So I'm working on that, and we'll see if that can happen. It'll probably be a weekend, because they're doing construction next door, they're expanding the building, they're adding another building. So I would be on either a Friday night, could possibly be a Friday night, or it could be an all-day Saturday, or it could be an all-day Sunday. But I'm just putting it out there for you all. If you're interested, please let me know. Like I said, I'm working out the details. I have to talk to the person that schedules the events here to see what we can come up with as far as a schedule, because I don't want to be setting up and then I have to tear down or move it because somebody else is coming in. I want a huge time slot to be able to offer this to you. So again, thank you for coming. Thank you for staying. Thank you for hanging out. Thanking you for putting up with my idiosyncrasies and figuring this out. I understand. Somebody mentioned earlier, why don't you do this on Facebook? Well, I've had too many issues, and I know I could have 500 people watching my stream right now, but I would rather have two dozen people watching a quality stream than have hundreds of people watching and having it spinning wheels and glitching and stuttering and all the other problems I've had in the past. I want my streams to go out and not have to even think about it. I want them to be the best quality sound for you. That's why I put all the extra work in setting up the microphones and setting up all the instruments the way they are, getting the cameras so at least you can see me. I've got some other things I'm working on for visuals, some meditative visual stuff. I've got the hardware working. I just don't have it quite dialed in yet. So that's why we didn't have it for today. Maybe the next time we'll try that out again. I've done it once before, only because the cameras I had at the time were so bad that you really, I was just a fuzzy blob. Anyway, enough of my ramblings. Thank you again. And we'll see you next round. I know that there's a new moon coming up. I believe it's Monday. I think it's the 11th, which is Monday, or the 12th. I don't know exactly. I believe it's new moon. There may be a stream for that. I'm just mentioning it. I have to see what my schedule is like. I want to thank you again. Namaste.